Hello, Jeff.
Hello.
How are you?
Very good.
We have a couple of questions for you. Is it true that you soon will be Russian citizen?
Yeah, I mean that's the word. We have a lot of people helping. We have Mr. Jarnowski from the Social Democratic Party, and some other people that are helping me get my citizenship. So we're just waiting and hoping that Mr. Putin signs so we can officially be a Russian citizen.
Why did you decide to do this?
You know, people have done it for different reasons. Sometimes like economic reasons to avoid taxes, sometimes because they want to start business in Russia. I'm doing it because I feel like I'm Russian. You know, I spent a lot of time there. I've been to over 30 different cities there. I've spent, you know, many months there over the last few years. And it's the people, you know, the people have been very generous and out and shown me their homes. And, you know, I've always been intrigued by Russia and the history and the, always admired the toughness of the people. But like being there it's hard to describe, and it's, you know, where your heart is. It's something that you can't pick and choose. It's like, oh, I want to be Russian, I want to be American, I want to be Belgian, I want to be, you know, British. It's like where your heart is, and my heart is in Russia. So for me, it was not a mental decision in my mind. It was a decision that my heart made for me.
Nowadays, there is a kind of fashion to be Russian and apply for citizenship. What do you think about it?
I mean, everyone's, like I said, everyone's got their own reason. You know, like a lot of my people that are my friends and that I hang around don't quite understand why. But it's something, like I said, it's something in my heart. It's not something in my mind. Oh, I think I'm going to be a Russian citizen. It'd be good for me. No, it's something that I feel like it was chosen for me by maybe the path I'm supposed to take. And, you know, it's where my heart is. So that's where I want to be.
How often are you visiting Russia, and which towns?
I visit Russia every 2 months. You know, I'm there in Russia almost as much as the United States. I've been to Siberia, Volgograd, you know, St. Petersburg, Moscow, Smolensk, every, you know, Penza, like countless cities, you know, 30-35 different cities. I've been all over Russia. I've been to Ingushetia, I've been to North Ossetia, I've been, you know, Sochi, you know, countless cities. But you know, different cultures a little bit, different people, but all the same, as far as like showing me, you know, thankfulness that I've been there, and showing me that they've opened their homes up to me, you know, and that's been the same wherever I've gone.
What is your favorite city in Russia?
Yeah, you know, St. Petersburg, I think, right now. It's the center of the world to me. It's culture, history, everything. You know, it's where the Russian Revolution started, which I, you know, have an affinity for. You know, the museums and the cathedrals and the, you know, the art, the orchestra, the music, I mean, the ballet. It's like everything, like arts, culture-wise, that you want to see is there to the highest level. So it's like first something to do, something, a place to visit. You know, I definitely my favorite city. Every time I'm in Russia, one of the things I learned is like they're the most generous people in the world. And you know, I say in interviews and talk to people, I have a 5-year-old daughter who I love, Willow, and so, and she loves these Matryoshka dolls. And so, a lot of cities that I visit, you know, I looked to buy, ask, hey, can I, I'm going to buy my daughter this. And they said, no, and they buy for me. So my daughter loves to collect these. She's got a few here, and she has more in her room. And but I've never bought one. They keep giving them to me every time I go. So every time I come back, she's like, Dad, you have one of those dolls? And I said, yeah, I have a Matryoshka doll for you. And so I get it. I have in my room a big collection of of little gifts. You know, last time I was there, a lady gave me a bar of soap just to have, you know, so, or they give me a pin or a hat or something that means something to them. One of my favorite things, you know, I'm a big hockey fan, and I guess, you know, people know this. So I got an old Russian Soviet national team jersey, which is awesome. So this is like one of my favorite things that I've gotten from Russia as a gift. And yeah, it's like I have a, you know, a couple of tubfuls of little items that I've gotten, you know, sometimes cookies, some stuff that but I'll never throw away, you know, and there's some plaques from the city or cups, stuff that, or especially a lot of pins from the different places. You see on the refrigerator here, there's magnets from places in Russia where people have given me, you know, different things and cups and stuff. So it's just like little things that mean something to them. The snowman Monsa mats. This is for when I did my Russian tour of Russia, the big Soviet tour. And they gave me a mug, a coffee mug, and moments of that. And here's another from Penza, from the Penza State University, from the college. So yeah, it's just a lot of like different stuff that I get from people. And the things I like about that is it's not the most getting stuff. It's like it means something to them. It's like it's some little small item that either a personal item or something I think I'm gonna use or something to remember their city by or remember that person by or that visit. So yeah, it's something that I guess when I have my gym in Russia, I'll put all these things on the wall or in a screen so I can like see them all the time. The linen, somebody gave me this as a gift. Obviously the linen with the communist, who I have affinity for a lot. And then this is my fight with Fedor. And then this is from America, dealing with some police officers here. So it's kind of like a little wall where I have some meaningful pictures. Obviously this is meaningful because it's a Republican National Convention of San Jose Police. After my fight, Fedor is my first time in Russia. So even though I didn't win this fight, it was a bad fight, it was an honor to fight. It was an honor to fight Fedor. And, you know, and he was a nice guy. And we talked, this is like in the locker room after the fight. So it was pretty cool of him to come say, you know, good, nice fight. This was given to me by a painter in Russia. And this, obviously, I mean, great, a lot of detail and a lot of, you know, work. And that's what I mean about people doing nice things that are meaningful gifts, not just gifts of, you know, my money or this or that, but like stuff that like it means a lot. Obviously it's up in my house, so it means a lot to me. These are two other gifts. Obviously the communist star. Here's an old, you know, traditional Russian hat. So you can't visit Russia without getting the traditional Russian hat. One of my favorite things to do is in Russia is go in the Russian banyan hot room. And so you need a hat, of course, to protect your head when you go in there. So I was given this as a gift when I go in the Russian banyan. And so I wear this in there as well. And I go there, it's obviously very cold in the winter, and sometimes I don't dress appropriately. But man, if you get sick And now if I get a cold or start getting the flu, that Bonnie Light clears out all that crap in your system, and it makes you like new when you get out. So I do that always. I like doing that before fights. Actually, the first time I was in a Rush Bonnie was I was in university, and my coach, who had been to Russia, had been to Tbilisi tournament, the old wrestling tournament that was very famous in the Soviet times. And he competed in this in Greco-Roman wrestling. And so he learned about Rosh Bonnie and how you're good. So before our conference championship, he had the whole team go through one. He rented out a Russian Bonnie from someone who had come over from Moscow in Oregon and made it. And so we all went through it. And for my first time, and now going back years and years later, I still remember it being like mentally it's kind of difficult to sit through it because it gets very hot, but man, you feel like $1 million when you get out. Wanted to make a garden, so I cleared out all the grass here, dug it out, and started putting some things in. We're going to make it like a scary garden. I mean, we have the one gargoyle, but we're going to make like some skeletons and like scary things, some scarecrows, just make it interesting. And we're gonna plant a bunch of things. The only thing we have right now is she actually dropped from Halloween. We had a pumpkin and she actually dropped a seed in here. And then we have like a vine growing there, but I'm gonna plant some pumpkins and potatoes and some beans and some other things just to make it interesting for her to like be able to tend to a garden and have to take care of it, get the weeds out. So she's helped me already because we took all the weeds out, and you can see we had to pour, we had to get 10 bags of dirt to put in here to fill in from the holes when we took all the weeds out. So this will be interesting. I've never had a garden by myself before, so it'll be kind of a fun thing to do with Willow. And Russia is like the capital of the world for growing and agriculture and growing vegetables and having gardens and wheat and this and that. So hopefully some of that expertise will rub off on me, and I'll be able to put a good garden together with my daughter. Sometimes you can see alligators in the canal. This is all fresh water, and sometimes there's alligators in there. They're not big. If they get over 6 feet, meaning they're over like 3 meters, then they come and take them away and take them to the Everglades where the swamps are. But we get the small ones in here like quite often. My third tattoo I ever got was this Russian star, the communist star, and says freedom is freedom, solidarity. And I did it in Russian because in honor of the Russian Revolution, meant a lot to me. That's where the first world social revolution happened. And it was, everyone said it was going to happen in Europe. It was pretty in industrial Europe, not backwards Russia, but Russia surprised the world. And you know, Marx and Engels were right about a lot of things, but they're wrong about that it would start an agricultural-based Russia, the revolution, the world revolution. And it changed the way that we look at things. And so I got this in honor of that, the freedom and solidarity. That's a lot. And I, in honor of communism, I got, you know, shortly after I got this, the hammer and sickle, prayer fighting communism. One of my favorite tattoo is my handprint of my daughter on my side. But my second favorite is I got in Moscow. I visited Volgograd. And I visited the Mamayev Kurgan. It's 2.5 times bigger than the Statue of Liberty. And it's largely ignored in the United States. Not very many people know about it. I didn't know about it until I went to Volgograd myself.
And what a, I went there at night with a bunch of people and we went inside, you know, underneath. They have a memorial with the everlasting, the torch light going, and the names of a lot of the 1.1 million people who died, the soldiers who died and the civilians who died defending Stalingrad from the Nazis. And it was really emotional. And my tattoo artist in Moscow, we were trying to decide what kind of tattoo would be the most meaningful or mean something to me. And he's actually the guy that came up with the idea. He said, you know, this, you know, you went to the site and this is Russia. This is Mother Russia. Mother Russia right here. And I did a fantastic job. But this is a very emotional, meaningful piece of art for me. And I'm very, very proud to wear this.
What do you love most about Russian culture? Your favorite writers, dishes, places, songs?
Russian culture is very, very unique. I heard it described one time, and this is perfect. It's an enigma wrapped in a mystery. And meaning like, there's too many layers of it to unfold. It's very complicated. The thing that stands out to me is that you have a lot of different cultures, a lot of different ethnicities, a lot of different backgrounds coming together, you know, from the Tartars to the Kazakhs to Ukrainians, like, and Siberians, like, all coming together to live in one area, in one piece of land. And despite all the cultural differences, they come together to make a great country, come together to make a great people, the Russian people, the symbol of like strength and prosperity. And like stands out to me as well is the culture, is like the strength of the Russian people. I've been through the harshest of conditions, the harshest of like circumstances, World War I. And then World War II, my God, like the turning point, the world would be a much different place right now if it wasn't for Russians, if it wasn't for the Russian resolve, if it wasn't for the people of Stalingrad standing up and fighting when all was lost. And my favorite writer, like someone that I read before, but I became involved and knew Russia, loved Russia, was Leo Tolstoy. My favorite, you know, World War and Peace, obviously a classic, but my favorite piece of literature by him is The Kingdom of God is Within You. And that mirrors everything that I believe about God, Christianity, war, humanity, morality, and treating one another with respect and dignity. And it's something that's my favorite. It's my favorite book. You know, he was, Leo Tolstoy was a rich aristocrat that gave up all he owned, not just for the people he did that, but for his ideals, what he believed in. He believed in something so strongly that he's willing to give up, not just die for it after he had all these earthly treasures, but he gave up his earthly treasures and sacrifice his own well-being for something he believed in, for the ideal that everybody's created equal and everybody should treat each other with respect and everybody should live in freedom without the threat of church, state overlooking and telling them what to do. When I first came to Russia, everybody told me, Russia, you got to try the borscht soup, the radish soup, the beet soup, everybody, like, it's the best. And I had it the first time in St. Petersburg, and, like, to be totally fair, like, it's good, but it's not, to me, it's not, like, fantastic. It's okay. I never really order it. The Russian dishes that I like are, you know, without knowing the proper names, the you know, in being in the Caucasus area, the North Caucasus, Ingushetia, North Ossetia, and there had for this time the bread with the cheese in the middle. Oh my God! And then having the lamb, the fresh lamb, the beef, the chicken, and the grilled vegetables. So everywhere I go in Russia, whether it's Siberia or Moscow, St. Petersburg, wherever it is, I order this every time. It's like I want the grilled meats on the kebabs, and I want the grilled vegetables, I want the bread with the cheese in the middle, and I think I would never get sick of this, just eat it. The difference between food in the United States and Russia, since I've been to both places and eaten both places many times, is the Russian food is much fresher. You know, everything in the United States virtually is frozen. You go to a restaurant, you go to your supermarket and stuff like that, you get meat, it's been frozen. And maybe it's not frozen right then when you get it, but it's been frozen, it's traveled a long way, it's got preservatives in it. You know, there's a lot of tasty American dishes, don't get me wrong, but the food is just, you know, given the population and, you know, distribution, and it's just not that fresh. The food in Russia is extremely fresh, you know, straight from your local, your farm, your butcher, wherever, and you definitely taste the difference. There's no, you know, it doesn't last as long. If you order it, you know, as a restaurant or facility, you got to cook it right away because it's not going to last very long because they don't put preservatives in it. But even the dairy tastes fresh, you know. So, you know, like something simple like the nuts, the mixed nuts with the fresh honey and mixing it together and stuff like that. I first tried that in Russia. Now even in the States, I get that all the time because I love it. So, well, one of my, you know, obviously the people are why I love coming to Russia, but I sure don't mind eating there. One of my other favorite dishes is pelmeni, the meat with the fresh meat with the bread and stuff. And you know, I first had this in St. Petersburg, but then when I went to the Caucasus area, they had special sauces that went with it, the pelmeni. Oh my God! Even whether the fights go good or bad, it's like something I always remember, like eating this. And even on the train, leaving Ingushetia, even though the food was fresh even on the train. Of course, they have chips and, you know, all that kind of garbage stuff. But we had the cheese bread and the pelmeni on the train. I remember eating this, and I remember the people looking at me, like in awe or in very strange. They thought that I would be riding on the train. And so it was kind of interesting. Had a lot of interesting stories to talk with the people.